In this video, I'll be going over naming ionic compounds, and this is just for simple binary ionic compounds. So to break that down, simple binary means that all of these elements, we're going to be able to predict the number of valence electrons they have, and then because of that, what ion they become. So basically, this means we're not dealing with any transition metals. So all the naming in this video will just be for all of those elements that we can completely predict what they want to do with electrons. And then as far as ionic compounds, that just means that we have a metal and a nonmetal. So I'm going to go over a few examples, both from going from chemical formula to name and from name to chemical formula. So let's start with just going over our general rules. And so our first element, that's always going to be the cation, which is the positive ion, and that's just the element name. So we look that guy up, and whatever it is, we're just going to name it. And so you always know, in this case, the metal is always going to come first. The metal is always a cation. And then the second element, the nonmetal, that's going to be the anion, the negative ion. And then that's going to have the same element name, but then we're going to replace that last syllable with the I-D-E ending, pronounced I'd. And so these are our two rules. And then just as a reminder, whenever we're doing any type of ionic compound naming, we don't use any prefixes. That's only when we're doing covalent. So let's just start with our first example. We have K2O. We look up K, we figure out that that is potassium. And that's really all we have to do, because our first element, we just say the element name. We don't have to indicate how many we actually have of this element in the name. And then for our second element, we see that O, we look up oxygen, and now we replace the last syllable with the I-D-E. Oxygen's a little bit of an exception, it actually becomes oxide. And so this is how we shorten it. And so the name for this is just potassium oxide. So we completely erase how many of each element we have going from chemical formula to name, which is gonna make it a little bit harder when we're going from name to chemical formula. But before we do that, let's do one more example. So CaCl2, so we look up Ca, that's calcium. And then we look up Cl, and that's chlorine. And now this one's really straightforward. So the last syllable of chlorine is just ene, and so we're going to now change that into I-D-E to chloride. And so here's our name. All right, and so that's the easiest part. Honestly, out of all of naming, just doing this simple naming is probably the easiest you'll ever get. And so now when we're going in the reverse direction, we have to do a little bit of math to figure out how many of each element we're going to have. So magnesium chloride, we see that. And so one thing you can't do, you can't just say, okay, magnesium chloride, I'm done. You can't do this because you can't just assume that you have one of each. Look at our ones where we went from chemical formula to name. We completely got rid of those twos. We just said the elements. And so for this, we have to do a little bit reverse work, and we have to look at the actual valence electrons and what those guys want to do before we can name it. And so magnesium, we look up right here. It's in our second column, so it's going to have two valence electrons, which means that when magnesium becomes an ion, it always becomes this. It becomes Mg2+. And then chlorine, we see it's over here in our seventh column, skipping all the transition metals. So it has seven valence electrons, which means that it wants to gain one more to become one negative. So the chlorine ion becomes this, Cl1-. And so now you have to take these two pieces and balance them before you can actually get to your chemical formula. And so right now, if we had one of each, Mg2+ plus Cl-, that wouldn't be balanced because overall our charge would still be 1+. So we want something that's a little bit more negative to get us to zero. And so we want to add another chlorine. And now we can see, okay, we have Mg2+ plus two chlorines that each have a negative one. That's going to be completely balanced. So at the end of this problem, we had to use one magnesium and two chlorines to get balanced. So that means that our actual chemical formula will reflect that, and it'll be MgCl2. All right, so now let's do aluminum oxide. So again, we can't just say ALO and be done, because that doesn't take into account the fact that we know how many valence electrons all of these have, and therefore we know how they're going to come together to form a charged balance molecule. So instead, we have to look up aluminum, we see that it's right here. This is going to be 3 valence electrons. That's few enough valence electrons that it wants to lose until it becomes 0. So aluminum wants to form an ion of Al3+. And then oxide. Oxide is oxygen. It has 6 valence electrons. And it wants to gain 2 to get to 8. So oxygen becomes O2-. And so now we have to balance these two. And this takes a little bit more because if we add up these right now, we have 3 plus 2 minus. That's going to be a charge of 1 plus. That's not balanced at 0. So we have to add something more negative. So we have to add another oxygen. And now we can see that our overall charge would be 3 plus 4 minus. That's still 4 minus, not at 0. So we add another aluminum. And now we're at 6 plus 4 minus, still not balanced out. So we have to add another oxygen. And now finally we're balanced because we have 6 positives from the aluminums and we have 6 negatives from the oxygens. And so at the end of this problem, to make a charge balance molecule that was at 0, we had to use 2 aluminums and 3 oxygens. And that's what our problem is going to represent. So we write out a chemical formula for aluminum oxide. It's going to be Al2O3. All right, so this is how you name simple binary ionic compounds. I have some other videos on other types of naming if you need help with the transition metals and Roman numerals, so feel free to check those out, and happy studying.